Hello student, in this video we are going to learn a very imaginative poem, The Clothesline, written by Charlotte Drute Cole. So let's begin the poem, The Clothesline. Hand in hand they dance in a row, hither and thither and to and fro, flip, flap, flop and away they go, fluttering creatures as white as snow. Here, hither and thither means in many different directions. Flip, flap, flop means noise made by the cloths while moving in the wind of the wind on the clothesline, and fluttering means moving lightly and quickly. So in the first stanza, the poetess Charlotte Drewitt Cole is talking about the cloths hanging on the clothesline. To her, they look as if they are holding hands, standing in a row and dancing merrily. She compares the clothes to the white birds that fly in the sky. So, in the first stanza, the poetess compares the clothes to the white birds that they fly in the sky, and when they hanging on the wire, they look like as if they are holding hands, standing in a row and dancing merrily because of wind or breeze. She compares the clothes to the white birds that fly in the sky. So let's move the second stanza. Like restive horses, they caper and prance. Like fairy tale witches, they wildly dance. Rounded in front but hollow behind, they shiver and skip in the merry March wind. So here, restive means restless or unable to remain still. Caper means leap, skip or dance about lively, playful manner. And prance means walk or move with high, springly steps. And wildly means violently. So in the second stanza, the poetess here compares the cloths hanging on the clothesline to restless horses that are leaping and galloping with happiness. As the cloths flutter on the clothesline, they form a bowl-like shape that is round at the edges and hollow in the center. The poetess also feels that the cloths are shivering and skipping in the wind that is very happy during the month of March. So, in the second stanza, the poetess compares the cloths to the restless horses that are leaping and galloping with happiness. And as the cloths flutter because of wind, they look like a bowl-like shape that is round at the edges and hollow in the center. The poetess also feels that the cloths are shivering and skipping in the wind that is very happy during the month of March. So let's move the third stanza. One I saw dancing excitedly, struggling so wildly till she was free, then leaving pegs and clothesline behind her, she flew like a bird and no one can find her. Here pegs means clip of wood or plastic to attach wet cloths to the clothesline. And gleam means here shine. So we will discuss this stanza in the next part. Till then, thank you.